Hi, and welcome to 3-Minute Adobe. In this video, we're going to have a look at one method of removing background noise, such as an air conditioner, from an audio clip in Adobe Audition. The method we're going to use in this video is the noise reduction process. To start, I'm going to double-click on the file from my media browser up here and open it up in the Waveform view. If you have a clip in a multi-track session, just double-click on the title bar of that clip in the track and it will open up in the Waveform editor. I'm going to open up the spectral frequency display, which is this button here, or Shift D on your keyboard, and it will bring up something that should look like this. I like to leave my waveform a little bit open up the top here so I can see where my dialogue starts and stops. And the waveform up here is showing me my amplitude or volume, and this display down the bottom is now showing me the frequencies in my recording. I'll go into a lot more detail about the finer settings of this process, but in this video, I'm looking at a really simple constant noise to remove, which is an air conditioner. Using the Time Selection tool, or T on your keyboard, I'm going to select a section of my clip that is just the noise I'm trying to remove. Be very careful not to capture any of the dialogue in your sample. It's a good idea to leave some room silence in your recording to have the ability to do this later. With this selected, open up Effects, Noise Reduction Restoration, and Noise Reduction Process. Leave the preset on default and click on Capture Noise Print. This takes the sample you've highlighted and says that this is the noise I want to remove from my clip. Deselect the sample, just click anywhere back here on your track, and move both of these sliders down to zero. With the loop function turned on, which is this button here, and the effect also turned on, as the clip plays through, start to move your sliders up until it's at a point that you're happy with. Because this process is destructive, it's affecting your original file, you cannot go back if you go too far. So get the minimum amount you're happy with and apply the effect. You can always remove more, but you cannot put sounds back. So we'll have a go at doing this now. This here is a sample of a recording with some background noise. In the background is an air conditioner, and we will look at how to remove that in this tutorial. Right, so I'm reasonably happy with that now, and what I'll do is put my cursor back at the start of the clip, and as I play through now, I'll keep the loop function on, which is this button here, and I'll also leave the power state on of this effect to begin with, and then I'll turn it on and off so you can have a listen to how it sounds as it plays through and the difference that it's making now. So I'll start this playing with the power on this effect turned on, and then I'll turn it off and back on again a couple of times throughout the playback. This here is a sample of a recording with some background noise. In the background is an air conditioner, and we will look at how to remove that in this tutorial. Right, so you can hear the difference there, and when you're happy with that effect, as it is with those levels, you can highlight and select a certain part of your clip to apply the effect to, or you can hit Select Entire File to apply it to your entire clip. And once you've decided the area of the clip that you would like it applied to, just hit apply, and you'll see now that where all those purple areas were of the noise, they've started to go much darker now as that noise has been filtered out. That's it for this tutorial. Click on the links below for alternative sound removal methods, as well as an explainer video on all those effect controls in the sound removal process dialog box. This has been 3-Minute Adobe. Thanks for watching.